can see there is a through hole in the middle, through hole from this face to this back face. So there is through one through hole, and there are two slots, cylindrical semicircular slots. So this is one slot, another slot is here, which we can see here. Here a similar slot is there. So regarding the object, it is quite simple, and let us see how its views look like. So from the front, when we see it, we will have semicircles here and here. We can show the lines of symmetry here, lines of symmetry, and one circle which is coming in the front, that is shown here, here, and at the same time we will show the lines of symmetry, and corresponding to this rectangle we will show this rectangle, means edges are there. So we will show, similarly we have the same type of rectangle at the bottom, so here also we will show in the same way. So for front view has no dashed lines, only continuous edges are there, so hidden corresponding to the visible edges. And in case of top view, we can see we have four dashed lines, and four dashed lines are corresponding to different portions. When two dashed lines are corresponding to the hole which is made into the object from front to back. So these two dashed lines are drawn corresponding to those, and two more dashed lines are there. What for these dashed lines stands? So they are corresponding to this extreme boundary of the cylindrical slot. So this point will represent the extreme boundary of the slot. So dashed line will pass from this point. So dashed line has been drawn here. Similarly, another dashed line has been drawn corresponding to this here. So here in this way we can complete the top view. And in the side view, that is right side view, we have this L type portion, where different edges which are making the L type, those are clearly visible, and here also similar edges are there, so we can show those edges here. And from the right side we cannot see this hole, so corresponding to that we will draw the dashed lines. Those dashed lines are drawn here. These are two dashed lines which are drawn corresponding to the hole, which is through hole from the left side to right side, means left to means front to back. There is another object which is the crank arm. In this you can see, regarding the object we can know that, sir? Yes.
Sir, in the previous slide, one show the previous slide.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Sir, what is this projection? Which angle projection?
All are first angle projection. So this view is the right side view, which is drawn on the left, and the top view is the below the front view.
Sir, for first angle projection, the fourth quadrant should be left empty, no sir?
No, depending on the object we can see. Like here in this case, we are drawing right side view. If right side view has been drawn, then we will show like this. If left side view will be drawn, then fourth quadrant will be left.
It is compulsory, sir?
No, we see we arrange the views like that. We don't remember regarding the quadrant we left. we only keep in mind that the front view and top view are related like this, that front top view will be always below the front view, and the right side view will be on the left of the front view, and the left side view will be on the right of the front view. This thing you can keep in mind.
Achha, okay sir, right side view on left and left side view on right.
No, yes sir. In okay, case of in you. Case of first angle projection. Yes.
Okay sir, thank you sir.
So this is the crank arm where two cylindrical portions are there on two sides. One is here, another is here, and in these two cylindrical portions holes are there. One hole is there in the this cylinder and other hole is there in this cylinder, and these holes are through holes. So, and these two cylinders are connected with the plate which is shown at the bottom of thickness 10 mm. So these two cylinders are connected like this. So let us see how the views will look like. If we view from this side, that means we are viewing the for the front view. So we will see these two edges, and after that we can have the cylindrical portion drawn on these two sides. So and two dashed lines corresponding to this hole, which can be drawn here and here. And similarly, another hole, we have the two dashed lines which can be drawn here. So that's all about the front view. And the top view, in top view you can see two concentric circle will be drawn here, and two concentric circle will be drawn here. So two concentric circles are here, two concentric circles are here, and after that we can draw two common tangent. One common tangent is this one, another common tangent is this one. So which are corresponding to the plate which is joining these two cylinders. So this makes the top view complete. And the right side view, in the right side view you can see we have a smaller cylinder first, then after that bigger cylinder. So in the same order we will put the cylinders. Like small, and the bigger cylinder also, it is bigger than the smaller one, so it cannot cover the smaller cylinder, cannot cover the bigger one, so it will be shown completely. And after that we have the holes in both the cylinder. In this cylinder we have bigger hole, so for that we have drawn two dashed lines, and two more dashed lines are there which are corresponding to the hole which are corresponding to those due to the presence of the hole in small cylinder. And there is another line, horizontal line here, and in the horizontal line we have two continuous lines, a small continuous line up to here only. So that the continuous line is corresponding to this line is corresponding to this edge. Okay, so here first two views we have already drawn. which may explain, and third view, which is right side view, we can see bigger cylinder and smaller cylinder, and the dashed lines corresponding to the holes in bigger cylinder as well as in the smaller cylinder. And this horizontal line, we can see this horizontal line is complete continuous at this small segment, and in the same way small segment has been made continuous, and in the middle we have dashed line which is corresponding to the hidden edge which cannot be seen from this side. So that's why this portion has been made hidden, dashed. This is another object which is iron casting. Here one thing different from previous cases, where we have hole in this case, in this casting, but that hole is not through hole, that is up to certain depth. Like here it is shown 25 millimeter depth is there, up to that only hole is there, and after that again material is coming. So we have only blind hole, so we can draw this in different way. Like here we have the object, and from the this side, for the front view, we have this cylinder. This cylinder, complete cylinder, is there, but at the bottom we have something different, which are two portions which are given, and they are covering some portion of cylinder. So corresponding to that, we will show this line, and how we will get to know up to what length we have to draw this line. For that, what we have to do, we have to draw top view first. First we can draw some part of the front view, and which is not which we cannot draw in the front view directly. We can first draw the top view. From there we can project it and get this location where this line is existing. So this is regarding the lower portion of the front view, and the blind hole which is drawn here with the help of three dashed lines. One dashed line is here, another dashed line is here, and at another third dashed line which is shown at the at this label where it has been shown as 25. So at 25, below 25 from the top, we will draw a dashed line like this. So in this way we will draw the blind hole, and top view you can directly draw because the two concentric circles are there, and after that we have simple part which can be drawn by using these edges. Dimensions of these edges are given already. So we can draw it completely as the top view. And the side view, in the side view, that is the left side view. So left side view, we can draw a complete cylinder. Complete cylinder should be there. And the blind hole, corresponding to blind hole, we should have the dashed lines like this. And this bottom portion, which is shown three rectangles are corresponding to these faces. One face is this one, another face is this one, another face, third face is this one. So three rectangles are corresponding to these three faces, which can be drawn at the bottom in the middle of the cylinder. So in this way we can complete all three views. So there are four problems which you have to do, and all four problems I have discussed. If still you have any question related to this or any other part of the syllabus which you have already covered, so because after this we will not use the orthographic view, although the things will be under the orthographic view only, but the topic will be changed. Topic will be sectional views. So here we have just orthographic view where no section has been drawn, nowhere section has been drawn. Other in other problems we can ask to draw section of different parts which we have just shown here in this case.
Sir, section means?
Section means you have to cut the object, means the object will be cut passing from some place, means some cutting plane will pass from some place through the object. So from there, if you see after cutting the object, how will you see what are the edges you will see, that will be drawn, and that is called as sectional view.
Sir, so after sectioning, it is again orthographic projection, sir?
Yes, orthographic projection will be there. Only thing is that you will use the sectioning. Cutting planes will pass from somewhere, and then some portion will be removed. And after removing the some portion, how will the object look like, that you have to draw by using orthographic.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
So why sectional views are required? Because means I have already shown the dashed lines for the hidden edges, hidden outlines. So what is the need of the showing the sectional view? In fact, sectional views are so used to explore the internal detail of the object. Although we know that internal detail can also be explored by using the dashed lines. But in some cases where many dashed lines are there at in a small portion, then we will not be able to know what is actually happening at the internal level. So there it is necessary to draw the sectional view, then we can get the clear picture of the object at internally. So then we use the sectional view. There we will study that this sectional view. So I have completed the today's discussion. So if you have any question, please ask.
Sir, in slide number 9, can you explain the side view?
Slide number 9. Achha, 9. Yes, this one.
Sir, in this side view.
Side view. In this side view, you can see from this side. So we have cylinder. So for the cylinder, what we draw? We just draw a rectangle. So for that, we have drawn a rectangle here. And after that, we have these three faces, which are also a small rectangle. This rectangle, and this rectangle, and this rectangle. And they are at the bottom. So we will show symmetrically at the bottom three rectangles. So corresponding to these three rectangles, we have shown here three rectangles, and the dashed lines which are corresponding to the blind hole, which is shown here, the up to 25 depths, these dashed lines are representing the blind hole. So this is regarding the left side view.
Sir, in top view, we can see that the part is coming out. But in side view, sir, we don't show the part coming out.
Reason behind it is that we are seeing from the left. When we see from the left, whatever portion coming out of the in the top view will be coming as cylinder. Like here, we can see the portion which is coming out, this is portion which is coming out. This is the portion which is coming out on both the side. This portion this is the portion which is coming out on both sides, this portion. Only this portion is coming, this portion is coming, the, which is beyond this this side. So beyond this, what your portion is coming is drawn here like this.
Okay, sir.
Sir, the outermost edges of the three small rectangles that are in the side view, sir, they are along the line of the diameters, the like the diametric edges of the blind hole.
Not necessary. It depends where the diameter comes. They are independent. So wherever they comes, they can be drawn at that location.
No, sir. In this diagram, I'm saying that this small blind hole that is there of 50D. Sir, these three small rectangles that are there in the side view, the outer edges are along that line, right? They are not along the bigger hole.
Bigger hole, only one hole is there, this hole. And these are related to three rectangle, right?
Okay, sir. Okay, understood.
Okay.
Sir, can you please upload these slides and all the previous slides also?
Okay, yes, sir. I will upload on this team only.
Okay, sir.
So I'm stopping it here.